Hello, today for review I've got new true wireless model. Now they are made by KZ. It's KZ E10. It's definitely not the first attempt by KZ to create true wireless model. Maybe actually it's not even second, I don't know exactly. I remember that some time ago there was some true wireless model by KZ. I thought about getting them for review, but they disappeared under radar somewhere, and now they appeared E10, and now it's, you know, it's more unusual, and because of that more interesting attempt to create a TWS model. And this time they've implemented a bit unusual construction. I will show it a bit later. And it's a 5-driver hybrid model. It's 10mm dynamic driver and 4 balanced armatures per each earpiece. Price is $60. Links will be in the description to the AliExpress. And let's have a closer look. Box is traditionally small with interesting unusual embossed polygraphy. Looks pretty stylish, I can say. And inside they are more traditional, so as you can see their case is noticeably bigger. It's like soap bar, not traditional lipstick like case. And in the accessory set you basically will have the minimum of accessories. Warranty card, manual, two additional set of tips, and really short piggytail USB cable for charging. So, as usual, KZ trying to save as much on accessories as possible. As you can see, case unusual. It's really slim, but I can say it's pretty stylish. Of course, smaller would be better, but anyway. So USB-C for charging, LED indicator, and inside you will find earphones themselves. And interesting thing here is that for pairing they should be in the case. It's not a traditional workflow when you pull the earphones out of the case and they will be in charging mode. So you open the case, then you have to press this button, LED will start blinking. Press button for 3 seconds, and now this breathing LED means that they are in the pairing mode. But I will pair them a bit later. Meanwhile, I will show you their unusual construction and design. As you can see, they've created these ear hooks, and here they've placed probably batteries or some electronics. I'm not sure about their internal build, where everything is located, but they needed more space inside of the shells, so they moved partially everything outside. And you know, this construction I really find really comfortable. I like it. Also, you know, they've used really good materials, so aluminium, zinc alloy, and nice silicone with soft touch plastic. Nice combination, really stylish looking, and really, well, maybe not premium, but at least really well done for the company that made cheapskate in their monitors few years ago. I'm not sure about their waterproof rating and their IPX rating. I've seen IPX5 mentioned somewhere, but actually I won't consider them as a waterproof actually. So nice ergonomic shape, fitting pretty well into ears, at least to my ears. Maybe smaller ears could be more problematic. Really extended spout, so sound isolation is above average, and because of this deep fit into ears, really good wearing comfort even during extended periods of use. Protective grille, lip for holding the tip, so everything that I pay attention is here. So maybe stock tips won't provide you the best fit because a bit bigger size could be a plus, but luckily there are some spin fits Of course, there is sensor control. You touch the front panel, you can play balls, you can call voice assistant, but you can navigate, skip tracks forwards or backwards. But unfortunately, there is no ability to change the volume from the earpieces, so you have to tap the buttons on your smartphone or on your player or somewhere else. As for work range, it's really source dependent, because with iPhone I'm getting 10 meters and even one thin wall on the signal's way is not an issue. With KN N62, for example, 5 meters is maximum range and wall is causing signal interrupt. Also, I think it depends on the amount of electromagnetic noise and interference around you on some busy street when there are a lot of Wi-Fi access points around you or some electric transport connection could be worse, but I didn't have any interrupts. As for work time, I'm getting about 3.5 hours, sometimes up to 4 hours from single charge in case, and charge took from 1.5 hours up to 2 hours in case. And as for microphone quality, well, in quiet room you will be heard really well. So there is no issues talking by phone. But when you are on the noisy street, noise cancelling here isn't the strongest part. But I must admit that every single true wireless model that I've tested isn't perfect in the noisy environment. Actually, the only true wireless model with good noise cancelling, it's Apple's AirPods. And also not bad is Huawei FlyPods Lite, but they are worse than AirPods. Maybe there are some other models, of course, but I didn't test them. And all other true wireless models, they are created for music listening, not for the calls on the noisy street. As for sound, it's pretty simple. KZ-E10 is like ZS-10 Pro, but with bit more treble accent. So if you are treble sensitive, probably it's not a model for you, but for me it's still okay. And you know, I think it's actually a good idea, because vast majority of true wireless models that I'm testing is tuned to be on the darker and warmer side with recessed treble. So I think it's good to have at least one model with accented treble. Maybe it's not universal and not everyone's cup of tea, but anyway. And also, I must admit that they have noticeable background noise when Bluetooth model is working. There is a background noise. It's audible during the quiet pieces or during the pause. Well, for me it's okay, but if you are sensitive to the background noise, just pay attention that it's present here. And let's proceed to the sound. So bass is nice, it's dominating, it's weighty, it has nice rumble, nice accent. Of course, it's not the fastest one, but pretty okay for this this price and for the dynamic driver in ear monitors. It's on the heavy side of things, but it has normal depths, actually pretty good depths for true wireless model, and it has this feel of sensation, it has this resonance, it has this domination. And as an example, let's move back. Juno Reactor Trans-Siberian, and it's nice, deep, punchy bass that is playing this trans line, and it's really nice. Give really nice sense of presence of low frequencies in these in-ear monitors. Mids are recessed, and actually that's why their signature is V-shaped, but thanks to the resolution of the balanced armatures, mids doesn't sound too congested, they doesn't sound too laid back. Thanks to the good resolution, mids are present and they are playing their role. Of course, don't expect, you know, some rich saturated mids. They sometimes are a bit thinner than they should be, but at the same time they are pretty resolving, and it's unusual sense, you know, for the true wireless in-ear monitors, because vast majority of cases they are dynamic drivers. So nice resolution, but bass and treble is accented. As an example, Actually forgot to mention, imaginary stage is a bit above average in width, and it's a good result for the true wireless models, and a bit below average in depth. And, you know, as an example, I've decided to use, where is it? PJ Harvey, the Ministry of Defense. Nice example of female vocal, and this in-ear monitors played surprisingly well, as well as other parts of this track, because it's pretty intense in terms of sounds and in terms of bassline and rhythm section here. And treble. So treble here is accented. It's not crossing the line for me of being comfortable, but it's coming really close. So for treble sensitive people, please keep that in mind. Once again, I will highlight that. At the same time, treble, of course, treble extension is not superb, but it's normal. But it's not because of the earphones themselves, it's because of aptx. So it's lossy codec, so it's cutting parts of the signal, and upper treble suffers because of that compression. At the same time, I like this accent. It's adding a bit more clarity, it's adding a bit more resolution, it's adding a bit more overtone, so sometimes it's managed to saturate the tune and make it sound more lively. So, as an example, it's Stairway to Heaven by Led Zeppelin. So, intro with, you everyone knows this tune, and intro with guitars sounding too muffled with vast majority of common true wireless models that are tuned on the darker side. And with this KZ E10, at least it's trying to be realistic. It's not 100% succeeding, but it's trying, and it's sounding pretty engaging, I must admit. So, to summarize part about the sound, it's a V-shaped tuning, typical for hybrids, with accented weighty engaging bass and pretty fun, clean and clear treble. I won't do compressions this time because I don't have any other true wireless model with similar sound signature. All other true wireless models are usually natural or on the warmer side of things, and this one is the only V-shaped true wireless model that I have, and basically it's really easy to decide do you want them or not. Instead, I will try to summarize my thoughts as much as my English will allows me. You know, I am really glad that companies are trying more sophisticated true wireless models. I am not sure is it first, or at least it's one of the first hybrid true wireless models, and I think in future we will see more of them. I really like KZ E10 subjectively, but of course it's not perfect model objectively. There are a few noticeable disadvantages. I'm not speaking about common for true wireless models, not perfect noise cancelling with microphone, or need to charge them in case. So I'm speaking about background noise. It could be better, of course. Maybe treble could be at least a bit less accented to suit more tastes. And of course, connectivity could be more universal in terms of other DAPs. I need to do more experiments because with iPhone results are okay. And of course, case is pretty bulky, so it's not also universal. And maybe some people will miss better waterproof. You know, it's really stupid mistake, because it could be a really good choice for some active sport or something like that, thanks to these ear hooks fit, and their fit is great and they are holding really well in place. But lacking of waterproof makes them barely usable during some workout. But anyway, I think that this model is really good, and it has potential. Maybe KZ will improve them in future, maybe not, but even in current stage they are really good with genres like electronic music, with some instrumental music. So basically the genre that benefits from the V-shaped signature. But if you want more forward mids, of course there are a lot of other models. You can check out my channel or some other views in the internet. But anyway, I think that KZ E10 are interesting. I can't suggest buying them blindly. I suggest to test them before buying, but they are really worth checking out. Thank you for listening and have a nice day.